Hello friends, I am Krishna Garg. I retired as professor and head department of anatomy, Lady Harding Medical College, many years back. Since then, I have been working in medical colleges, dental and physiotherapy colleges. I have authored number of books for medical students, including the 4 volumes of B.D. Chaurasia's Human Anatomy and Practical Anatomy Workbook. For dental students, a textbook and practical book. For nursing students, for BSc nursing, for GNM nursing, and for ANM students. And lastly, for the pharmacy students. Now we have come up with a manual of human anatomy dissection. This is the manual of human anatomy dissection. We have recently done this book. The dissection is both an art and science. Number of dissection manuals are available. The most popular one is the Cunningham's Manual of Practical Anatomy. Many of these are in 3 volumes. Some are in 1 volume also. But all these gives computer-aided or hand-drawn diagrams and not the actual ones. The idea of the book was given by Mr. S.K. Jain, who is the chairman and managing director of CBS Publishers and Distributors. After lots of deliberations, it was decided to do the book in only 1 volume. And this is complementary to the textbook of anatomy. The index of competency-based undergraduate curriculum for the Indian medical graduate 2018 has been provided with each of the 6 sections. The book gives a brief outline of the cadaver, that is the human dead body, how to obtain the cadaver, how to embalm the cadaver, how to take care of the cadaver when the dissection is being done, and how to dispose the dissected body after the dissection is complete. The instruments are given for the dissection. The chisel, hammer, and saw are provided by the departments. The scalpel and the forceps, the scissors are provided, have to be bought by the students, including the hand lens and the skin marking pencil. The dissection is done in various regions and they are put in sections: upper limb, thorax, lower limb, abdomen, head and neck, and brain. And each of these regions or sections have number of chapters. Upper limb has 8, thorax 7, lower limb 10, abdomen 20, head and neck 19, and brain 10. The highlight of the dissection are the photographs of actual dissection, not taken from the museum specimen or not drawn by the computer. These photographs will give nostalgia to the faculty members for remembering their carefree days during the dissection hall. These are the slides of upper limb which we have put in the book. This shows the slide of the axilla with the median nerve, ulnar nerve, and the radial nerve. Here is the diagrams, actual diagrams of the cubital fossa, showing the boundaries of cubital fossa and the contents of cubital fossa, median nerve, brachial artery, biceps, and the radial nerve. The diagram of the palm, showing the superficial palmar arch and the long tendons which are going to get inserted into the digits. The muscle of the palm, the adductor pollicis with its transverse and the oblique head. Coming to the thorax, the diagram of the mediastinum of the left side, showing the arch of aorta and the descending aorta with their branches and the intercostal nerves and vessels. The other one is the heart with its incisions, which are lying anterior to the phrenic nerve. The diagram of the right ventricle, how to open the right ventricle, and the structures structures in the AV groove. The diagram of the right ventricle, the pulmonary trunk, the right ventricle, and the pulmonary cusp. Diagram of the left ventricle, the left atrium with its valve and the thick myocardium. They called the tympani, they called the tendini, the papillary muscles, and the thick muscle of the left side of the heart. The lower limb diagrams show the femoral triangle, the femoral artery, the femoral artery, femoral vein, and the place for the canal, femoral canal, and we can see the great saphenous vein draining into the femoral vein. The popliteal fossa showing the upper medial boundaries with lots of muscles, upper lateral boundary, biceps femoris, and the content, the superficial content is the tibial nerve. The diagram showing the beginning of the great saphenous vein lying anterior to the medial malleolus, the dissection of the sole showing the plantar interossei and the dorsal interossei and the plantar arch with the deep branch of the lateral plantar nerve. The abdomen diagrams are the ones which show here the transversus abdominis muscle. Lying on the transversus abdominis are the intercostal nerves which are lying between the internal oblique muscle and the transversus muscle. Here there are the abdominal viscera, the transverse colon, ascending colon, descending colon on the right and left side, and the mesentery with the intestines. Here is the beautiful diagram of the C-shaped duodenum with the head of the pancreas, neck of the pancreas, body, and the tail. It is seen that the tail is quite broad and it is not as narrow as the tail. It really means the diagram of abdominal aorta showing its various branches which are labeled. The head and neck part shows the diagram of the muscular triangle of the anterior triangle and even the digastric triangle with the anterior belly of digastric, posterior belly of digastric, and the submandibular gland are seen. This is a very beautiful diagram of the facial nerve dividing into its various branches and as it is passing through the parotid gland. The diagram of the lateral, the photograph or diagram of the lateral wall of the nose showing the air sinuses and the superior, middle, and inferior nasal conchae. The section through the tongue showing the important life-saving genioglossus muscle, geniohyoid, and myelohyoid muscle. Lastly, the section on the brain shows the meninges, the dura mater with the branches of middle meningeal vessels. The beautiful diagram through the cerebellum showing the arbor vitae pattern of the cerebellum, the gray matter and white matter, the white matter showing the dentate nucleus. The superolateral surface of brain showing in red the motor area and in green the sensory area. 3, 1, 2 is sensory and 4 is motor, and the same areas continuing on the medial surface in the paracentral lobule. The red is the motor area and the green is the sensory areas. These are the diagrams. Each of the chapter begins with a learning objective, what all one has to learn, the overview which gives a broad outlook of what is given in the text, the competency achievements and the steps of dissection in simple language and including the diagram. At the end of the chapter, we have the viva-voce questions. These viva-voce questions can be answered if one has read the dissector and done the dissection and read the textbook of human anatomy by B.D. Chaurasia. the sections on 1 to 5 shows the various joints, the movements at the particular joint, the main muscles doing the movement and their nerve supply. This particular slide shows the muscles and joints of some of these of the upper limb. Coming to the brain, the all the flow charts of the cranial nerves are shown. I am showing the course of the trigeminal nerve as the nuclear columns, the cores, and the various branches of thalamic, maxillary, and mandibular, and on the side, course of the facial nerve with the nuclear columns, with its all its long tortuous course, and its finally branches. And this is a slide which shows the comparison between the fifth and the seventh nerves, and these are the nerves which are most often asked in the examinations. The end of each section shows the spots on all these respective sections. This is showing the spot on abdomen and pelvis. These are useful in practical examination. The spot is shown, the questions are asked, and at the back there are the answers to check on their skills and knowledge. The book can be used not only by the medical students, but it can be used by students who are doing BDS, Bachelor in Dental Surgery, or Masters in Dental Surgery. It can also be used by students of Bachelor in Physiotherapy, Bachelor in Occupational Therapy, and students of Ayush, that is Ayurvedic students, yoga and naturopathy students, Unani students, Siddha students, and students who are studying homeopathic streams. There is a request to give the feedback of the book at the email drkrishnagarg@gmail.com, and to please send some actual photographs of the dissection. And last but not the least, that to ensure the students buy a set of bones for themselves. Without the bones, the study of anatomy is incomplete. I hope I have given you a crystal clear picture of the contents of the book, and thank you very much for giving the valuable time. Thank you.